Sepsis is the body trying to fight an infection. That infection has got out of control and you're in a state of sort of attrition warfare.
What really attracted me to sepsis research is if you predict it early and put patients on antibiotics, you can potentially save lives. There has been a few attempts in the past 10, 15 years to predict sepsis. However, many of those algorithms, they had a fairly low performance. Over the past few years, with better analytic tools, such as deep learning, artificial intelligence tools, we have been able to improve the accuracy of these models. Definitely setting up the data was probably 70% of the work. It took us a year to figure out how to get the data, in what format. There were times that I thought it's just not going to be possible.
The first time we built the model, it was based on only 400 patients. And our latest data pool is about 450,000 patients. With the advent of better AI algorithms, we are able to look at now many, many different indicators. In our latest work, we were looking at 65 different indicators.
Some of them comes from laboratory, from patients' vital signs. Some of them are coming from bedside monitor data.
And it's becoming impossible to process this data on our desktops locally. So that's where some of the cloud resources becomes very, very useful.
Shimim is one of the smartest people you'd find anywhere in the area of sort of time series analysis and deep learning. He's working much more on the AI side of things. I'm working much more on the system side of things.
In our current system, we've sort of tightly coupled how you're fetching data from bedside data sets.
On the Google Cloud, we have the data layer where all the data is coming in and is being refined and getting to a point where it can then go down the processing layer. At that stage, we found data flow ends up being a very effective tool. It's a nice managed service on the Google Cloud platform that allows me to transform data and has a very nice user interface to try and author those jobs and then reuse those jobs. Once data has been cleansed, gotten ready for computing, we make use of TensorFlow. TensorFlow is this core library that we use for developing and then deploying our machine learning algorithms. So the way the overall system was developed, one of our goals was to make sure that one can easily add and develop new algorithms, such as a sepsis prediction algorithm.
Implementing the algorithms on the cloud allows us to have an infrastructure that can scale up and down. If I want to monitor 100 patients versus maybe tomorrow 10,000 patients or even a million patients, the cloud gives us the ability to not worry about the infrastructure and focus mostly on improving the algorithm itself.
Nurses or the physicians can see a dashboard such as this.
At any given point in time, the score is telling us the chances that the patient will develop sepsis in the next 6 hours.
So it kind of gives somebody a high-level view and you can quickly see or sort patients that are deteriorating versus the patients that are stable. In this particular case, the algorithm thinks there's a 0.41 risk of sepsis developing. The top three reasons why that's going to happen is the current temperature, the heart rate, and the chloride. Then when you kind of go into the details of it, then you see, okay, what were the trend lines? Now you're talking in the language of a clinician. You're describing what your algorithm picked out in this vast pool of signals.
A clinician, when they see a patient, is limited really to the experience that they personally have had or maybe even read about. With machine learning, what you can do is in a matter of seconds, compare this patient to a million or 10 million, and so bring to the clinician's attention things that are worth looking at.
We were able to catch 85% of septic patients and at the same time maintain a low rate of false alarm.
Medicine is a very inertia-laden, risk-averse profession. Those of us who went to medical school, we learned how to do it the way our teachers taught us how to do it.
The goal is not to replace the physician. What we're doing is giving him or her resources to make a better, more informed decision in a very quick amount of time.
This is not going to be restricted to advising on sepsis. It'll be advising on who needs a blood transfusion, how quickly we can wean somebody from a respirator, who's at risk for developing an abnormal heart rhythm. And we will learn through this process what the optimal partnership is among patient, family, caregiver, and computer.
This is real. This has the potential to help real patients.